just what guided me this way. Oh, stand unshaken, amidst the crash of the world. May I stand unshaken, amidst the crash of the world. The pines, they often whisper, they whisper, but no tongue can tell. From the deep water, may he know the depths of the well. May I stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. May I stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. Oh, traveler, what have you seen? Were there crossroads? Where you been? I once was standing tall, now I feel my back against the wall. Stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. May I stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. But I could not see. And I don't wonder, as a wayward son, what was a haunt to be haunted.
Hello? Anyone here?
Dear Uncle Tacitus, I do so hope you enjoyed your vacation. Lucky you, leaving like that. And you always suggested you were too old for travel. I hope you and your cousins enjoyed yourselves. Me and your grandnieces have decided to take a trip of our own, as the place has become so dreary and godforsaken in your absence. We've gone to visit relatives. From my daddy's side, you are not yet acquainted with them. In Lacay, a small village just north of Saint-Denis. It's buggy and muggy, but apparently neither is too bad at this time of year. Please come see us when you can. Yours sincerely, Caroline.
Well, thank you, darling niece Caroline.
Milton keeps sending us back every day to search this place.
There quite clearly isn't a gang of outlaws held up here.
Someone is here. Look, those are fresh footprints. Looks like someone might be here right now.
Sure, someone is here. There's always someone everywhere.
Well, let's look around, see if we can find something for Mr. Milton.
Mr. Milton? I'd like to find a poisonous snake for him.
That's enough, Mr. Johns. You take Mr. Bunter and search around back.
Mr. Orley, let's head inside. Gentlemen, be careful.
Yeah. Now, come on. Yeah. Yep.
Arthur! Arthur's here!
Oh, Arthur! Oh, you're alive!
Just about.
Come inside. Come on, it's raining. Hey, everybody, look who's here.
How y'all doing?
Hey, old man, wake up.
Hey, Arthur, they got John.
Good to see you.
Yeah, he got arrested.
He ain't hung yet?
Not yet. They moved him to Sisica. He's been working on a chain gang.
Howdy.
Oh, look.
Yes, they got John.
Okay, okay.
Hey!
How'd you folks find each other? What happened? Can somebody get me a cup of coffee or something?
It was Mrs. Adler who saved us, Dutch. After the robbery in Saint-Denis, she got us away from the camp before the Pinkertons turned up. Then Mrs. Adler and Mr. Smith drove away the degenerates who were living here.
Mrs. Adler, we... Oh, you.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
It's been real hard, Dutch. We've been surviving, but only just. What we gonna do?
Things have been tough. There ain't no doubt about that. Trust me. I am gonna get us out of here. This ain't over.
Ain't none of you folks interested in our adventures?
Guess we're more interested in escaping the hangman on our tail?
Cheerful nymph of the prairie, wasn't you, Abigail?
Oh, sure. My fair heart jumps for joy when I set eyes on you, Micah.
We buried Hosea, Dutch. Charles and I stole his body from the law one night and gave him a proper burial. It was real nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, here you is. Well, I asked everyone I could find, and eventually someone knew, said you fools were out here. Shit. Give me a drink or something.
Get your own damn drink.
In our absence, Mrs. Adler here has been looking after things. Now sit down.
This is Agent Milton with the Pinkerton Detective Agency.
Already?
On behalf of Cornwall, Kerosene, and Tar... The United States government and the Commonwealth of West Elizabeth.
Here we go.
We are here to arrest you. Come out with your hands up.
Give them to a count of five, then give them everything. Actually,
let them have it.
Everyone get down!
Arthur, follow me!
You're fine, did you, Bill?
This is not fair.
Stay down, Ollie.
Arthur, follow me!
Where are we going?
This way! There's a trapdoor into the other house! We can try to flank them!
Strength and you may mistake it for brutality.
There is no escape for any of you. I shall hunt you to the ends of the earth and the end of time.
This I killed your friends.
Really starting to irritate me.
Arthur.
Oh, man. Bill and Sadie.
You okay, son?
Sure.
We ain't been back for more than a few days.
What do we do, Dutch?
Clearly, we need to leave. It'll take them some time to regroup. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw, start packing up. Javier, you and Bill, get out of here. Go scare off any scum still loitering about. We need a couple of days. Now, please, gentlemen.
What next, Dutch?
We just need some time. I need some time. Now, we can't go east, because then we'll be in the ocean, so we're gonna have to go north, I guess. I just need somebody to buy me some goddamn time, one of you.
You'll figure it out, boss. You always do.
What are you gonna do about John, Dutch?
John?
He's in jail.
Well, we'll get him. Abigail, just not yet.
There's talk of hanging him.
It's not gonna come to that.
Dutch!
Not now! Mesa, not now.
I'm begging you to. They're gonna hang me. Break my... the boy's heart. Please, do something.
We will. Okay. I'm gonna go figure out how we rescue this bastard.
Now?
Yes, now. Give me a Doyle's Tavern, a Million Avenue.
Okay.
My Lord, what a goddamn mess. Everything.
not sure what happens next. The whole thing has been hard on all of us. Most of all on Dutch, who seems half crazed by all we've gone through.
Mr. Pearson!
Gonna be a long day.
How you coming along there?
I'm moving as fast as possible.
Well, good! All of you! Hurry this along! We need to go! Do you want those men to come back and murder us once and for all? No? Then hurry up! We need to get moving again! Quick! All of you!
D4.
You okay there?
Working it all out. Once and for all, Arthur.
What now?
We're back, and I'm sitting here, and I am contemplating the great journey of the sun and considering a famous chess move. Those Oilean actors of a mediocre justice, the Pinkertons, and their benefactor, the depressing millionaire, Leviticus Cornwall, they want us, Arthur. They want us. And they are going to have us.
Well, maybe they ain't the problem.
Meaning?
I don't know. It's just, well, I can't help but feel we would have been better running off someplace else.
But the game ain't over, Arthur. I mean, I ain't played my final move, but
I guess I'm more interested in saving lives than winning a chess.
And maybe life ain't such a thing to cling on to so tightly.
No doubt. What about the women?
You sound like Hosea. I miss him.
I asked you a question.
What do you think?
We can't stay here. That much is obvious. Where are we gonna run to? I mean, they chased us from the west. They chased us over the mountains. They ran us into the sea.
Arthur, do you have my back?
Always, Dutch. But there's more than your back to worry about. We need more money. We've been on the run for months now. And I seen you killing folk in cold blood like you always told me not to. And I'm sorry, but I can't help but think that if we
there is country in Roanoke Ridge past Butcher Creek, I believe we could hold.
Okay.
And you and Charles, you could take folks up that way.
Micah and I need to do some reconnaissance.
I ain't got a final plan yet. Arthur, I ain't got it. I just need time. I need time and no traitors.
Charles, will you ride with me?
Always.
Things all right?
Where are we headed?
Up past Butcher Creek.
Smurfy brute country.
That's why I'm asking you to ride with me.
I understand. What are we doing there?
We're looking for a place to hole up. Even the law won't follow us up there too willingly.
Yeah. I did some scouting up there while you boys were away.
And?
You'll see.
I know the way. Follow me.
I'm back, girl. We need to get this done fast. The Pinkertons will have reinforced in another day or two.
Yeah. The sooner we get out of here, the better. It's quite a ride up there. I saw some canoes near the bridge upriver, which would take us right up to Butcher Creek. Might be quicker. What do you think?
Yeah, a boat's probably a good idea.
Okay, good.
It's good to see you again, Charles.
You too.
Thanks for what you did in Saint-Denis. Real brave drawing them off us like that. I was worried you and Abigail had both got yourselves killed.
I found a spot to lie low for a while, then managed to get a ride with a wagon of workers heading out to the fields. Abigail said she somehow managed to slip away when they grabbed Hosea.
You did good getting the others out of there, keeping everyone together.
Everybody was pretty shaken up when I got back to Shady Bell. It was a tough few days. I couldn't have done it without Sadie.
So how did you find that spot back there? I assume the skulls on sticks weren't an addition of yours.
Old Strauss knew about it. The locals are terrified of the place, so we figured that might buy us some time. And it did. Until one of you brought the law with you.
Where did you end up again? Cuba?
Oh, not exactly. An island off of there, called Warma. Landed ourselves in a heap of trouble.
Really? A tropical island? Isn't that just what Dutch wanted?
I guess it didn't exactly live up to his ideals. Anyway, I ain't always sure Dutch knows what he wants anymore.
Perhaps not, but he's always managed to figure things out in the past.
I know. Hey, you're right. It's been, guess I just miss Hosea and his, wisdom, you know?
Of course. There's the bridge. There should be some canoes down to the right here. Well, I see one anyway. And that'll do. Come on. Creek is a few miles upriver. So I spent some time up this way while you were gone. I ran into Rainsfall and Eagle Flies, the Indians, and I've been trying to help out a bit where I can at the reservation. Things are bad there.
That's not a surprise. They seem to be in a lot of trouble and no more.
Some men there spoke a lot about the Murphy gang that hides out in these caves. We're gonna need to be careful. They're animals. Everyone is terrified of them.
Great! Dutch didn't mention this.
Well, hiding up here, it's not a crazy idea. This is a spot nobody comes near, even the law. But just be ready. It won't be pretty.
So be it. Butcher Creek up ahead.
Who are they?
The locals.
They don't look too friendly.
Wait till you meet the Murphys. All right, let's walk it from here. Good evening.
Can you help us? We're trying to find a spot called Beaver Hollow.
We don't take kindly to outsiders around here.
Come on, they're not gonna help us. I'm pretty sure it's to the north, up the road here.
These Murphy Hills, stranger. Might watch where you wander.
It's a bit of a walk. You could grab those horses if you want. Probably won't miss them if we get them back by morning.
Okay.
Don't want to come around here. Ain't exactly a welcoming place.
Lots of stories of people going missing around these parts. Just recently, a stagecoach from Annisburg disappeared without a trace coming through here.
Guess that's good for us. Assuming these inbred bastards are willing to part with their home, which I'm sure they won't be too pleased about.
No, but I believe they hide out all over Roanoke Ridge. These caves are just one of their spots. Which is why we should keep it down. They might have lookouts around.
Okay.
You see that up ahead? Slow down, keep it quiet. It could be some of them. I say we dismount here and follow them on foot. See where they're going. Follow me and stay quiet. Let's get closer to him. Come on, up this way. Definitely Murphy's. I say we deal with them from here. You take one, I'll take the other.
I need a breather.
Quick, Arthur.
Already? For Christ's sake. Oh, why don't you carry the body for a bit, huh? Why do I always gotta do the...
Good job.
We must be close now. Let's stop and have a look from the top of this hill there.
Stagecoach went missing. Jesus. They must be in the cave. All right. Let's get on with this.
Okay. What'd you think? We can head into the cave or flush them out with dynamite.
Dynamite be safer.
Yeah. Let's be quiet and... they don't come out. Let's get this over with. Okay. Get in a bit closer and then throw it into the cave. Hey. Dynamite, Arthur.
That poor girl out of the cage.
Stay away from me.
We ain't gonna hurt you.
Don't touch me.
It's okay, miss.
Please don't kill me.
Just calm down. Go. Where are you from?
Annisburg.
What do we do with her?
Take her there and I'll go get the others.
Sure. Miss, you okay to ride on my horse a little? I'll keep you safe. Annisburg, right?
Yes. They
It's okay, miss.
The others, they killed them.
You're safe now. Just try to breathe.
They're animals.
I know. It's all right, miss.
Why would they?
Some folks is just evil. Ain't no point trying to explain it.
I haven't slept in days.
I know. What's your name, miss? It's okay.
Meredith.
You're gonna be home soon, Meredith. And this'll all be over.
Thank you.
Where in Annisburg?
One of the mining cottages. If you get me to the main street, I can show you from there.
Okay. Just try to relax now.
Main Street. It'll be easier to walk from there.
Yeah. Yes.
Oh.
Here.
Oh. Thank God.
Which place is yours?
Up at the top of the hill. It's near the blacksmith.
Come on, man.
Ma! Ma!
Meredith! She's alive! Oh, she's alive!
She saw some pretty bad things, I'm afraid, man. Murphy Group guys.
Oh, my darling. How did you manage to?
I just ran into them and found her.
Oh, thank you. Here, let me give you this.
Oh, that's okay, ma'am. You just... keep her warm and keep her safe. Mrs. Downs?
Oh, no. You leave me alone. You just leave me alone!
Thanks, buddy.
How you get on?
Okay. Found a girl. Took her home.
Oh.
You and Micah find anything?
Maybe. I think maybe I found our old friend Mr. Cornwall.
You did?
Yeah. He's buying a stake in the mine in Annisburg.
Relentlessly ambitious fella, isn't he?
Micah and I'll sniff about, see if he knows we're here, and exactly what his plans are.
So, Dort, did you miss me?
I found her drunk in Saint Denis.
You're back. How jolly, Miss O'Shea.
It's funny, you sack of shit.
Back and drunk.
The master, the Lord God Almighty.
Calm down.
I won't be ignored. Dutch Vanderlyn, I haven't him. I ain't her. Or any of your stooges.
Calm yourself.
You don't owe me nothing.
Miss.
I don't owe you nothing. Nothing.
Okay.
I'll spit in your eye. I did. I told them!
I'm sorry?
Yeah, I told them, and I tell them again. Now I've got God's ear.
You told who? What?
Mr. Milton and Mr. Ross about the bank robbery, and I wanted them to kill you.
You did what?
I loved you, you goddamn bastard! Go on, shoot me!
She's crazy. She ain't worth it.
You told on me!
Oh, you're
you
not
betrayed
so big now,
me!
What?
Just calm down.
Arthur!
She's a fool.
Get her out of here. You know the rules!
You're not so big now! Hurry, Your Majesty!
You...
Damn!
She knew the rules, Arthur. What the hell is wrong with you? Mr. Pearson, Mr. Williamson, get this body out of here and get it burnt.
Okay.
Now get back to work, all of you! Quit your lollygagging!
Right.
Get back to work! Yeah.
Miss Crenshaw, a nasty woman. You think I wanted to shoot her?
You seem to like it. I saw that beady look in your eye.
You're drunk again,
and you're a fucking murderer.
She broke the rules.
She did no such thing. She was in love. You sour-faced old crow. Goddamn you. Murderer! Murderer!
Oh, hell.
So you think Dutch has lost his mind, Arthur?
I don't know anymore. I'm not sure I even care.
Well, Micah says you've been saying crazy things about him.
Micah. Keep an eye out for Micah, Bill. He says a whole lot.
Been a while, girl.
Another day.
Buongiorno.
Mister, are you okay? Mister, are you okay? Are you okay, Mister? Mister, you don't look so good.
Let's get you to a doctor.
Come on, it's not far. Just down the street here.
Give me a minute. Give me a minute. I'll be fine in a minute. I'm fine.
Nearly there, just around this corner.
Now you head in there, friend. Go on.
Can I help you?
I need a doctor.
Oh, just one second, sir.
Come in, pal. Come in.
Mister, I need some help.
And so it seems. And that's doctor, mister, to you.
I'm sorry.
I was joking. Look, friend, I don't mean nothing, but you got money? I mean before I start treating you, because I got a family.
Yeah, I understand. Here, let do
you. Sure. Thank you. Now, what's wrong? I mean, what appear to be the symptoms?
Well, I think you've heard them. I'm coughing.
Is there any blood?
Sometimes.
Okay, now here. Breathe. Again. Let me see your tongue. Say ah.
Ah. What is it?
It's not good news.
Well, I guess that.
You got tuberculosis. I'm really sorry for you, son. It's a hell of a thing.
What do you mean?
You're real sick. It's a progressive disease. You'll be... Now, the best thing is rest. And getting somewhere warm and dry and taking it easy. Now, is that possible?
Sure, I can just take my winters in my country club in California. No, it's not possible.
Well, like I said, I'm real sorry.
Yeah, well...
Now, wait. Let me get you a little bit more energy today.
change what's done. We can only move on.
You have it in you, I can tell.
Any problems coming in?
Nah.
Guess they know now we ain't in the city.
Who, Mr. Milton's friends?
Yeah, they've had patrols out ever since you boys disappeared. Well, at least you're alive.
For now, yeah.
What happened in,
Guama?
Yeah.
Nothing nice.
What happened to Dutch? Because he seems...
I don't know. Seems as... What began happening in Blackwater began happening years ago, maybe. A slow decline, I guess.
What do you mean?
I ain't quite sure. What happened here?
I started gathering people up as best I could after you boys left. And John, you know that part.
I do.
And Hosea?
So that too.
Hell, we got Lenny's body out as well. Robbed the morgue and buried them together. Follow me. Yeah. Whoa.
So, what's your plan here?
Well, I figure before we do anything, we need to make sure John's even still at this prison.
And how do we do that?
We need to get up high enough to get a proper look at the place.
What? It's on an island, ain't it? Unless you're planning on learning how to fly.
That's exactly what we're gonna do. I found us a hot air balloon.
You ain't serious.
Now, the pilot, or whatever you call him, he thinks we're just in it for a lesson. Bit of a tour. He's quite the character. I think you'll like him.
You know, I'm impressed. You really stepped things up, ain't you?
Hey, we didn't know if you was even coming back. Whole thing hit folks real hard. You can see it. Karen's gone falling fully into the bottle. Strauss is a bag of nerves. Swanson, well, Swanson's actually gone and cleaned up his act. So, I guess it ain't all gone to shit. I'm just happy you boys were able to find us. Javier said he got the letter I left at the post office.
That was a good idea.
Until the Pinkertons showed up. Oh, by the way, I've been hunting O'Driscoll boys. Killed two of the sons of bitches at a campsite last week.
What?
Yeah, seems they've drifted down this way now.
You're a busy woman, Sadie Adler.
Oh, she a beauty, ain't she?
From here on the ground, yes.
Mr. Bullard?
Hmm.
Mr. Bullard.
Ah, Mrs. Adler. It's good to see you. Good to see you. Ah,
this is my friend I told you about, Mr. Morgan.
Ah, yes, Arturo Bullard. At your service, sir. At your service.
Arthur Morgan.
Well, it's a nice, fresh day for flying, sir. A day like today, an Icarus would have made it across the sea. Ha ha ha. Have you ever flown before, sir?
No.
Oh, it's quite a thing. Quite a thing. Now, put these on and hop in.
Well, ain't she coming?
Well, women can't fly, sir. Are you insane?
They can't.
Oh, no, sir. It does terrible damage to them, to their vapors. I thought everyone knew about that. Why, a delicate flower like Mrs. Adler? Heavens above! Or below. Ah.
Where'd you find this guy?
I told you two would get on.
Are you sure about this?
Certain, sir. Quite certain. Mrs., let us away. Wish us luck. I've only crashed twice. Now, pull on that rope and hope for the best.
Ah! You boys have fun.
How did you get out of this?
Okay, here goes nothing. Right, time to catch a few vapors of our own. It's a little overcast, but I'm expecting some good wind once we're high enough. We should still have some decent views over the river. Now, one hates to be coarse, but on the subject of ablutions, liquids over the side, solids, do your utmost to levy the situation until we land.
Okay, Mr. Bullard.
I had a client once who fell foul to a rotten oyster on the ascent. A decidedly harrowing experience for all involved. Keep going, sir! We need to get up above the clouds. It really is stunning up there. You'll have seen nothing like it. All right, then. Let's break through these clouds.
Oh, my God.
Yes, heavenly indeed. Quite remarkable, isn't it? Feels like we have a nice westerly wind, so keep her around this height. This particular vessel is state-of-the-art, sir. Imported from Europe. You won't find more than a couple of these on this side of the pond.
So long as it works. You sure you shouldn't be doing this?
Not at all. A child could operate this with a little supervision. Besides, Mrs. Adler told me you were very keen to learn the ropes. We have plenty of those.
She did, didn't she?
We can see for miles now. Arthur and Arturo, how perfect is this? My mother was a keen student of the Italianate. My brother's called Baldessario, so you could say I got off lighty.
Look, I'm trying to concentrate here.
Did you breakfast in the city this morning, Mr. Morgan?
Not exactly.
Well, I have a boiled egg in my pocket here that you're very welcome to.
I think I'm all right, thank you. Recalling the ablutions discussion.
Well, just say the word. You interested in the pursuit of aviation?
I didn't, exactly. Mrs. Adler thought she'd surprised me.
Ah, a very nice woman. And no shrinking violet.
Definitely not.
I prefer slightly more feminine attire on a lady, but variety is the very spice of life, as they say. Or is it, though? Did you know they locked up the man who wrote that in a mental asylum?
I did not, Mr. Bullard.
See that building up ahead on the island? That's the infamous Sisica Penitentiary. We shouldn't fly too near to it, though, sir.
Sorry, we're going in for a closer look.
What do you mean? Mr. Morgan, please, this is most irregular.
Well, you want a happy customer, don't you?
Look, this isn't funny now. What on earth are you doing? The guards are bound to spot us.
Calm down. They won't care if we stay high enough. I'm just looking for a friend of mine.
A friend?
Poor bastard has a habit of being in the wrong place at the wrong time. I heard they got him working the fields in a chain gang.
Dear God. The wind. Well, this is most unusual.
Relax, Mr. Bullard. Here, take over. You keep us well away.
I'll do my best. This filly isn't the easiest to control, you know.
Nope, not there. Best try another spot.
Should we, think about heading back?
That could be him. Yep, that's him. What are you doing?
They're shooting at us!
I can see that.
Ascend! Ascend! Didn't I tell you this would happen? Oh, the wind speed is picking up. We should stay at this altitude. It's heading northwesterly, so that should take us back to land. Dear God, I'm shaking like a leaf!
We're in the clear now, Mr. Bullard. You can get up.
Good Lord! My heart is pounding! I must say, the specifics of this job were not described to me at all sufficiently.
Well, it's done now.
Annisburg.
Sure.
Good Lord. Is that Mrs. Adler?
Where?
Being chased.
Yes. Try and get us near.
Will there be more trouble, sir?
I expect so.
I'm starting to rather enjoy this.
Hey! Say! Come here!
Mrs. Adler has a lot to ransom for.
Yes, she does.
Most excitement I've had in years.
Chang!
rope! Come on! Grab the rope!
Us. Get behind something. This ain't over yet. These goddamn O'Driscolls.
You can't leave it for one day?
Just kill these sons of bitches!
Stay out of trouble for one goddamn hour. You got that poor bastard killed for his troubles. I kind of liked him.
They got Combe, the government. They got Combe O'Driscoll. They're gonna hang him in Saint Denis.
Hang him? Okay.
Mm-mm. He's already been tried twice for murder and found guilty.
Sure, no doubt he'll escape again.
No, he won't, because we're gonna make sure of it.
We have our own problems with the law, in case you ain't noticed.
Dutch will want to see him swing.
Sure, Dutch. He wouldn't even help us with Marston. And our situation is really messed up right now. You know how things is.
Bastard's gonna swing. I'm gonna make sure of it.
Closely followed by Marston!
You saw him?
Yes, in the fields.
Okay. Then we go rescue him.
From a state penitentiary?
No. But from the fields? Yes. That we can manage.
It's well guarded.
Guarded, sure, but not behind bars.
No, it's not behind bars.
So, that's how we'll do it. Bust him from his work detail.
I guess.
It's best just the two of us go.
The two of us is all there is, anyhow.
Good, because two is all we'll need. I'll get us a boat, a little one, and we'll sneak in and get him out of there. Meet me at Copperhead Landing. Thank you, Arthur.
Whatever you say, boss.
I heard that.
I really can't. I must come. He's my husband.
I know he's your husband, but it's gonna be... Well, it's gonna be violent.
I insist.
Insist all you like. Ain't happening. Arthur, tell her.
Tell her what?
She ain't coming with us to collect her husband.
Abigail, you ain't coming. That's the end of the matter.
See, there you heard him. Now let's go.
But
nothing. It'll be quicker and easier with just the two of us. Plus, John will be calmer without worrying about you. Ain't complicated.
Well, I ain't the crying sort, but I'm real grateful.
Yeah, we know you are. We'll bring him back to you.
Thank you! Thank you both!
We'll land the boat in the morning when the prisoners come back out to work the fields. The place is surrounded by marshland. Should hopefully give us a bit of cover to move in close enough to find a spot to look for John.
Then all we gotta do is take out all the guards and row our way out of there. Seems simple enough.
Yeah. How many times, Marston?
Okay, bring us over. We good? Let's head for that watchtower.
Okay.
Stay low.
Come on up.
All right. Where's John? Grab that rifle. You can use the scope.
Hey, I think I see him. There's a group in front of that barn just to our right.
Oh, yeah. I see two guards. Okay, take them out and let's go get our boy.
Okay. Let's go over there and see.
Okay, come on. I think one of those guards is still moving. Arthur, let's keep moving.
Where is he? You see him?
No. You, mister, you know John Marsden?
He ain't working today. Put the gun down, lady.
No. You put the gun down. Now. Where's John Marsden?
He ain't in the work detail today.
Okay, well, I guess we'll go and get him together. Try anything, I'll blow your damn head off. You clear on that?
Yes, very clear.
Oh, no, you don't.
Come on, partner. Hey, why don't you apologize to the lady for pointing a gun at her?
Excuse me?
I said apologize.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Ain't no harm done.
So, where do we go?
Towards the entrance, I guess.
And who's in charge of this fine establishment?
Jameson, sir.
Jameson who?
No, Mr. Jameson. Heston Jameson.
Is he a nice fella?
He's been quite an exacting boss at times.
I look forward to meeting him.
They're not gonna let you do this.
Well, that's gonna be up to you, my friend.
Oh my God.
So, you a popular employee, my friend?
Not especially.
Well, I guess we're about to find out.
Come on, march him straight up to the front gate.
You better hope someone in there actually gives a damn about this fool.
Guess we'll see. We're gonna have to shoot our way out of here regardless.
Don't shoot!
Okay, friend, be cool now. Just do as I say.
Drop the goddamn guns!
Jameson! Is Jameson in?
He's inside, Denise.
They got Milliken! Got him and gonna kill him. Unless you bring me John Marsden. Right now. You got 1 minute. I'm counting. One, two, three.
Milliken, is it?
Yes, sir.
Will you count for me? I got talking to do.
Yes, sir. Of course, sir. from 1 or 4.
Oh, very funny. No, we must be at 11 by now.
11, 12, 13.
Faster.
14, 15, 16, 17.
Now hurry up. 18, 19, well, this poor fool's gonna get his brain shot out. And over what? For nothing.
Milliken, don't stop counting. I can't hear you.
Hurry up and bring that asshole out here, you bastards. Come on.
Don't cry, buddy.
I don't want to die.
Yeah, I know. I know. Hey. Hey. John.
Well, you too.
Now, no funny business. Or Mr. Milliken here will stop crying once and for all.
Okay. Today's your lucky day.
Let's go!
Take my pistol! Let's clear these and make a run for it!
This is...
Seems to need rescuing, Marston.
Nice to see you, Arthur.
There's some fellas coming here. Don't look too friendly. We best get out of here.
Come on, boss. Let's move. I'll row. You shoot.
Seriously?
Let me. You're a better shot.
All right, fine. You just relax and enjoy yourself, John. Leave the real work to them as can still handle it.
Thanks.
Keep them off us.
Turn that boat around or we will...
I think I liked you better when you was all trussed up like a prize chicken.
No doubt.
Oh, hurry up!
They're gonna be on our tail soon enough if you boys keep wasting time.
Oh, that's us told them.
Hey, Arthur. Thank you.
Don't mention it.
Let's go. We should get out of here quick before the law gets wind of this.
So what the hell happened in Saint-Denis? Is Abigail all right?
She's fine. Jack is too. She managed to escape when they got Hosea.
Hosea? That still don't seem real, somehow. All them years. Arthur, he was like family.
Yeah, we lost young Lenny too.
No. What a goddamn mess. And did we... What about the money?
Lost somewhere at the bottom of the ocean.
What? How the hell did that happen?
We hit on a boat. It's the only way out of there. The boat went down in a storm, and we ended up stranded on an island somewhere near Cuba.
Cuba? Wait, you're gonna have to tell me all this again.
It's a long story, but things ain't been good, John.
You're telling me?
We're holed up now in the mountains to the north, near Roanoke Ridge and some caves there. The Pinkertons caught up with us again, and we had to move.
Yeah, seems Molly ratted us out, the bitch. So she's dead too.
Jesus! Maybe you should have just left me to hang.
And, I should warn you, Dutch didn't want us breaking you out. Said it wasn't the right time, so... Might not be the hero's welcome you're imagining.
So much for no man left behind. I can't stop thinking about this. In the bank, when they grabbed me, he saw it. Felt almost like he had a moment to do something and didn't.
Dutch ain't himself right now. Or maybe he just ain't who we thought he was.
Guess we don't need to worry about who's his favorite no more.
Guess not.
To me.
We told you we would.
John! What are you doing here?
It's good to see you too, partner.
I meant I hadn't sent for you yet.
I will.
But I said that.
Yeah, I know what you said. I felt different.
Is that so?
Yes.
And when Spring and John brings the law down on all of us, what then, Arthur?
Well, I guess we'll have another fight on our hands.
Loyalty, Arthur, it ain't. I had a goddamn plan! John, you are my brother. You are my son. I was coming for you.
They was talking of hanging me, Dutch.
They was talking. They was talking. And now they may come and hang us all.
Arthur!
Oh, sorry.
I was miles away, thinking of, I don't know.
Dutch said to tell you he and Mike have gone to Annisburg. Something about Mr. Cornwall.
Cornwall. Okay. Thanks, Mary Beth.
Ah.